So I start the modeling process with my three cylinders, and I'm going to reshape those cylinders to match the image reference that I'm using. And when I'm working on it, I'm working entirely on rows of verts, not touching any single points. With the exception of that point right there that I just moved down, we do want to move the point at the bottom of the body downwards. But in general, we're only focused on rows of verts, and this is because we're trying to capture the overall shape of the body, and we don't want to get caught up in details yet. So I'm moving the rows of verts for the body around to match my reference. We'll see that I am rotating some of these rows to suit the curvature of the spine a little bit better. Most notably at the top of the body, where we're trying to capture a little bit of the neck shoulder shape. But I'm using entire rows, rotating entire rows, scaling entire rows. I just want to make sure that I'm not pulling on any single verts or making changes to any single verts at any point. And then I'll move on to the arm. The arm, we want to make sure is less wide, narrower at the wrist, obviously. And at the shoulder, the arm is going to be about as wide as the torso. And at the top of the arm, you'll note that I'm rotating that edge row at the top of the arm to match the angle of the body in that area. And this is going to facilitate connecting these two components when we merge the body and the arm together later. And I'll add a couple more rows so that I can create the curvature of the shoulder. But other than that, shaping the arm is relatively easy. It is relatively cylindrical. We don't have to put a lot of effort into it. With the leg, we'll do the exact same thing. I'm going to rotate the top of the leg to match the angle of the body. And then I'll reshape the leg just to match the reference. And especially with the leg, I have so few rows of verts that I'm not really going to be able to capture the shape of the leg very well. So I'm just going for the overall whole. I'm not trying to capture any fine detail in this case. And now I'll use my duplicate special with instance turned on to just flip my objects over the axis. That way I'm seeing the entire character, but I only have to create half of it at a time. Now I'm going to create the neck. So I'll grab those edges at the top of the body and I'll use the edit mesh connect components to connect around. And then I'll extrude that new row that that new disc that I've created up. And that top row becomes the base of the skull, and the bottom row is where the neck and the shoulders and the traps kind of meet all in that area. So I have to pull that one up a little bit. I definitely have to pull the top one up a little bit. And that allows me to reshape the upper torso area. And I'm going to start by adding a subdivision to the upper torso using my insert edge loop tool. And that's going to allow me to connect the arm. And with the arm, we'll see that there's a hexagon at the base of the shoulder. That's what we need to plug into. So if we look at the body, we don't see a hexagon. But if we move those two bottom verts and I move that central vert up, now we see our hexagon. And that is exactly what we're going to connect our arm to. So now I've got the body, and we'll see that I've only got half of it, so at this point I'm going to delete the half of the body and mirror it over using duplicate special. And now I'm going to move the verts from the body up to snap to the verts of the arm. So I'm connecting the body to the arm. And before I combine these two, I'll delete the original duplicates. Then I'll combine them. Then I'll duplicate special. And now I'm free to merge verts in that area. And I can start to pull my verts around to get a more even distribution of verts. The shoulder is a really difficult area when it comes to deformation animation. So we want to make sure that we have a very evenly distributed group of verts, even topology, so that when we do start to animate, it works very well. Now we'll see at the top of the shoulder, I've got these two triangles that are a problem. We don't want triangles in the shoulder. So I'm going to cut another row of edges around the arm on the body side of things. And we'll see that there are a couple triangles that are left there. I'll get rid of those using the collapse tool. And now I've got these two rows. And at the top of the shoulder, I need to figure out how can I continue the rows around on top of each other. And if I just connect them straight across, we'll see that we did end up with some quads, but it just moves the triangle. So I'll connect across and I'll delete those corner edges. And now I do have some nice quads at the top of the body. And what I'll actually do is I'll actually insert a little space though so that I can create an entirely new set of connections and collapse that together. And we'll see that I've got a nice set of rows and edges in that area. Everything is a quad. And now I'm just going to spread those verts out a little bit better so that when it comes to deformation, my rows and my verts won't be clumped on top of each other. And now I'm just reshaping to match the reference a little bit more closely. With the neck, we want to remember that the neck is lower in the front, a little bit higher in the back. So matching my verts to the shape of the clav in that chest area. Okay, enough noodling. Now it's time to turn my attention to the leg. And we'll remember that we drag that single cap point downwards at the bottom of the body, which leaves that point at the bottom of the body. And I'm going to grab the three faces on the edges there and delete it, just leaving those two triangles in the middle. And I'm going to connect those two across to each other by inserting verts along each of those edges. And then I'll just merge those verts to center. So now I have a quad at the bottom of the body and an open socket where I'm going to be able to plug the leg into. So I'll adjust those verts together. And then I'm going to add another set of subdivisions on that ring at the bottom of the body to pull those out, to round them out a little bit. And I'll end up with something that'll replicate the bottom of the pelvis a little bit more closely. And adding those edges is important. That's going to give us something to match the leg to. And with the leg, we have that base cap shape. And just like the arm, that's what we match up to the body. And at this point, I'm just going to start snapping verts together. And the correspondence should be pretty good because we created our body with 12 axis subdivisions and we created our leg with 8. And those two numbers should match up really well. From the center under the body to the side of the leg, it's a one-to-one correspondence. It only gets a little bit tricky in the back where we've got some triangulation and we can't connect things as straight across as we were able to do in the front of the body. So I'm going to add another subdivision to that ring in the center of the body, and that will leave me with a triangular shape gap. So I'll pull the vert from that new shape that I've created over and meet the leg, and now I've just got a triangle. So I'll extrude edges straight down from the torso and snap those directly to the leg. And I'm going to merge my verts together. And at this point, I've got a connection. So I can combine my body and my leg, and I can merge the verts together. And now I just have to worry about those triangles. So the front of the body works out pretty well. So I'll duplicate special with my instance turned on. And now I've got the two halves of my body. And I'm going to add some subdivisions into the torso. to round out the shape a little bit better. But that'll also help me with deformation when it comes time to set up the character. So with that leg, we're going to resolve that triangle by cutting all the way around from the front of the leg to the back of the leg. And that'll leave us with that triangle being quadded out. And you'll see how I got rid of those verts there. And I'll cut another row straight from the bottom of the butt across the leg to give me another set of quads. And this one I'm only going to take out as far as the side of the body. And you'll see that I left it open on the side right now. And I'm going to use these extra edges that I'm cutting in to better define the shape of the butt. So I'll push in the center row to create kind of the empty volume in the center. And I'll cut straight up from that new triangle I've created. And this new set of edges will allow me to create more of a rounded butt shape. And we'll see that we do have a triangle up at the top of the butt where it meets the base of the spine. But that's not a dangerous area for deformation, so we're not worried about that too much. And this is a good stopping point. I'm going to keep noodling for a minute. I'm just moving verts around, and I'm doing it by comparing my reference in the front view and the side view, just to try and match the base shape of the model to my reference. And with our model, we want to try and make the rows of our topology conform to the shape of the character's muscles and bone structure so that we get a nice agreement between our topology and the construction of our body. And at this point, I'm playing around with the waistline of the character. And I'm moving it around to kind of suit the shape that we're seeing in the side view for her pants. And at the same time, I'm playing around with shapes in the butt to create more roundness in that area. And now I'm going to finally smooth it using the smooth proxy just to see the shape of it. And it looks like it holds up pretty well. Now the basic model is done, and it's time to turn to detailing our mesh.